It's like what amounts to a workstation. Maybe a place to repair armor. At least they're not being lost in vain. Oh, it feels like it. That was weird. And I was right about it connecting. Let's see where it connects. Come back later and explore it. I need to get to where the moths are just so I can read the Elder Scroll. Hopefully Serana will be there by the time I get there. Something has happened where she's basically disappeared. Forgetting about that trap. Oh. If this gate had still been standing, this place would have been a bit more secure, I suppose. They could have locked this down, and likely locked this gate as well, and had this fire going. That way, the only way to get to it is to go through pretty much any guards that would have been stationed in this area. This fall crease way down yonder. Or near fall crease. Nearby is one of the best shouts in the game. That is... this one. Which I need to unlock it. Very useful, especially if you're gonna play a stealth mode. Plus there's a dragon priest in the area too, and if you're going to go with an archer build, it's the best one to do since it is just mask. He drops his mask. Lot picking and the archery make it worth it. I haven't done too terribly much. Alchemy though. I probably should, since that could provide healing pots. Probably. Dragon.
Nice.
he found another target. A whole bunch of mages. The dragon flew away, however. That happens from time to time. Likely what happened is the mages attacked. I'm very bad with dragon names, but the one you can summon. He'll be sticking around for a while. Drop off all this stuff in the house I have up here. Still got one of those hearth fire homes I need to buy. That's the one south of White Road. Got the two, north of White Road, I think. I guess. Directions mixed up in this game. Slight overkill if you killed a mud crab. The one I'm missing, oh yes, to the south, it's around here, in this area. I think this one is probably the best one, in terms of location of how it looks. This one's fairly nice too, except I found out there's a giant that can go through the area. But in terms of a safe house, it works rather well. Since it's not too far from White Run, and it's along the way to the north. Or one of the ways through the mountains. It looks like this one doesn't move until you advance in the Dark Brotherhood quest, even if you help him. for weapons. That's creepy. That's even worse. Ooh. Yeah, that's bad too. Don't think I would make a trophy room again. A cow? Why? At least the dragon skull makes sense. Some of these aren't so bad. There's no way I'd want to build that. Hey, let's just make, statues of undead things. This house won't be creepy at all. I think was a kitchen. Well, at least a setup as a kitchen. Oh, a display case. This is what I should have worked on. Yeah, this display room. Waste. Should have gone with storage, I guess. Well, at least now I know. Tanning rack I can put down in here. Oh, that would save a trip or two. Still having to go up and down again. I need to start building the shrine as well. At least the good thing is that will get me eventually to being able to alter magic items. Need to sell those. Couple of these I want to disenchant. And now to do the moth quest. You have to do it because the moth priest made a mistake. Reading the Elder Scrolls causes blindness because you don't necessarily read the scrolls. It's sort of kind of like the scrolls place the information in your head. But even that's not completely accurate. But a side effect of that is, I guess those people who aren't destined to read their scrolls will eventually go blind. And it's debatable if the player, that'll happen with the player as well. Because there's one interesting theory about the Elder Scrolls and what they actually are. And one of those theories is the fact that the player is a living Elder Scroll. But that this could simply be from the mechanics of the game. The reason behind that is that all characters or all people in Elder Scrolls have a destiny, which is written in the Elder Scrolls themselves. And the Elder Scrolls can change everything, even if it makes absolutely no sense, and even if the changes contradict themselves, which is why all of the endings of Daggerfall are happened. Even if all of them, it doesn't make sense for all of them to happen at the same time. The Elder Scrolls allow that to happen. But the player character doesn't have a destiny. There's, several stories out there with that concept. One of them is by David Eddings. And one of his characters, Sparhawk, is said to be like that as well. A character without a destiny, where they make their own destiny. The character does that as well. Which is why the characters, player characters from Elder Scrolls are described almost as Elder Scrolls themselves. If that makes any sense. Or living Elder Scrolls. Or even tied to the Elder Scrolls. Although the downside to it is that either an Elder Scroll or another mechanic, and this is explained in-game, forces the player character to be in a certain place at a certain time. Which is how you end up in dungeons. Even though you might or might not have done anything to deserve to get there. Or why you cross the border at a very specific time. And this is heavily hinted at in Morrowind. more so than the other games. Although, interestingly enough, Daggerfall is sort of the exception to this rule. It's the only game in which you don't start off as a prisoner, per se. You start off underground, of course, but it's described as the boat you were traveling in basically crashed. Unlike the other games, you can create a backstory in Daggerfall. And in that, you can be a prisoner. But that's before the story starts. One possible background is that you're a prisoner, and in order to secure your freedom, you're sent on a mission to Daggerfall to meet with someone. But that's one option among many. There's another option where you used to work at a tavern, and one of the Emperor's sons hid out there, and during the events of Arena, your character was protecting the Emperor's son, one of his sons. That is another possible background story as well. And as a reward, you're given the mission. That basically kicks off Daggerfall. Lots of tangles up ahead. Sounds like skeletons. But it just could be the bandits in the area. Alright, so bandits. The one by the water didn't attack me, so he might or might not be with the bandits. The hunter? Why did the hunter attack me?
Ha!
leave that horse alone. The owner of the horse is still alive. Okay, now this is unique. If they had said Hunter, I would have left him alone. But he could have attacked somebody. I left him alone. He might have ambushed someone. The thing I don't understand is this Hunter. Why did the Hunter join the attack? There's the skeletons I was hearing. No markings, so no telling how old these are. Right into a trap. have a pretty fast reload time. Yeah, the crossbows do. I think. Now I just need to find the right paths to get to this next area.
No sign of him.
All over now.
Aye.
How far back am I? Oh, here again. This means ambush ahead, three of them.
What was that?
That's it. That's all you've got.
Damn, not doing all that much damage to him. That was lucky. And this one tanked it. Crazy. Yeah, it's a weird sound for healing. There is going to be an ambush of vampires later. I just don't remember if there is an ambush just outside the place. Entering the place should hopefully cause Serana to appear. Because she's required for it, I believe. Yeah, she is. I'm not sure where she was before. She just disappeared.
Not very impressive, is it? If this ends up being a wasted trip, your friend Dexian and I are going to have some words when we get back.
It isn't wasted, it's beautiful in here.
Wow. Look at this place. No one's been here in centuries. I doubt there's any other place like it in Skyrim. It's beautiful. Now all we need to do is crack down one of those canticle trees.
You're right here?
Moth like that bark as much as Dexian said they would. Look at them. They've definitely taken a liking to you. And unless I'm seeing things, you're starting to glimmer.
Thank goodness I'm not a vampire. Because that would be very weird. Let's switch it out to third person. I think I saw something up there. Not particularly glowing, but... The other option is just to see it this way. I see it now. Unless that's another mist.
Whoa.
Yeah, it's definitely visible now.
What we were waiting for. Let's head back up there and see if we can read the scrolls. What now? It's not like anything else in Skyrim, I can tell you that much. From now or before. There's probably groves like this all over Tamriel. Most people just don't even know what to look for. Are you okay? Almost thought I lost you there. You went as white as the snow. I never trusted those damn scrolls. Who knows what those things could have done to you? Just look at Dexian. What about Ariel's bow? Do you know where we can find it? Then it's almost over. We can finally put an end to this ridiculous prophecy. Where is this Darkfall cave? Then let's get going. I want to get there before my father has a chance to track us down. Not much. If you read any history, it shows up from time to time, but it's a hard thing to track. As far as I know, though, it's never been held by a vampire. That would be a new one. Ariel is one of the elven gods. He's with the rest of them in Aetherius. The way I've heard it, the sun represents the connection from our world to theirs. Supposedly, the glow draws its energy from the sun itself. Who's there?
Rude as all get out. There's one advantage to being a werewolf, no matter how many times they hit me with that consumption spell. I won't be infected by the vampire disease.
I'm not gonna die like this. Oh, what is it?
I guess that's stuff that she basically told me, even though it was interrupted a little bit. Not stealing. Painful.